Hello, this is a podcast or mole vodcast number one. In this particular vodcast, we are going to talk about the mole, the basic properties of the mole in chemistry. And we're not talking about the mole that burrows in the ground like this one. We're talking about the chemistry mole, which is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. All right, so on this podcast, we're going to kind of talk about that number and what exactly it means. So one thing that you're going to have to kind of get through your heads is that the mole number is not a mass measurement. All right, sometimes mass in chemistry is not very useful. Sometimes actually that is deceptive. All right, so mass is very deceptive when it comes to different chemicals and different ways things react. So for instance here, say if I was talking about a particular amount of broncos. Well, let's just say we had 6,000 kilograms of broncos, and we were going to compare that to about 840 kilograms of Dr. Wentworth. All right, if we had more than one of them, suppose, and just suppose that each of these broncos weighed 500 kilograms, and each of these Dr. Wentworths weighed 70 kilograms. All right, so I could divide these two numbers and find out the quantity of each. So if I take 6,000 divided by 500, I get 12, and I get the same thing over here. So I still have the same quantity, all right, but I have different masses, and that's where this idea of the mass being deceptive comes in. All right, although I have the same quantities of things, I have different masses. All right, so in chemistry, we're all about measuring quantity, and the thing that we use to measure quantity is the mole. So the mole is basically a number, is a number of objects. Okay, it's like a dozen. It's like a dozen. Okay, so a dozen could be 12 of anything. 12 of anything. All right, so a dozen could be 12 of anything. Right, just like a mole could be a mole of anything. It just so happens that the mole is a very, very large number. All right, it's different from 12. It's a lot more than 12. It is 6.0022 times 10 to the 23rd. All right, so to fathom really how big that number is, let me write it all the way out for you. All right, it's basically 6.02, basically followed by, so that point there is going to be followed by 23 placeholders. All right, so there's one. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. All right, I'll fill in kind of the placeholders here. So that is the big number that a mole is. In fact, this number is 600 sextillions. All right, so we're talking about huge quantity of atoms or huge quantity of something. All right, so if I had 600 or 600 sextillions of Dr. Wentworth, it would weigh an enormous amount. All right, so this is too really big of a number for us to understand. All right, but the thing you need to understand is that one mole always equals 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. All right, this was named after a famous scientist who did a lot of work with the mole. His name was Amedeo Avogadro. All right, we maybe wrote that down in a previous podcast or vodcast. So Amedeo Avogadro did a lot of work with this and came up with the mole number. All right, so now it's time for some mole jokes. So a lot mole has created. Actually, there has been a mole day. It is I think it's October 23rd, which is times 10. All right, remember October is month is 10, so it's 20, October 23rd at like 6:02 in the evening or in the morning, one of the two. So it's actually a mole day. But first mole joke. What happened? What kind of fruit did Avogadro eat in the summer? Avogadro, remember Avogadro developed the mole, and it was watermolons. Why was there only one Avogadro? Because when they made him, they broke the mold. Next one. How much does Avogadro exaggerate? He makes mountains out of molehills. That's a little bit maybe old for you guys to understand, but he makes mountains out of molehills. And finally, last one. What is Avogadro's favorite kind of music? Rock and roll. So it's rock and roll. All right, I have a video I can show you guys. Ask me to show you that video. All right, so the mole is a very huge number. Like I said, it's very, very huge. It's hard to even write out, but just remember, it's a number that measures quantity. All right, not mass. All right, so it relates quantities to each other. All right, not practical, really not practical for anything but chemistry, because we're measuring small particles, measuring or measure small particles like atoms or molecules or particles. I don't know why I wrote that down twice, but I wrote it down twice. Moles are an SI base unit. Okay, remember when we talked about that at the very start of the year? They're universal. All right, so they're a base unit. They're a base unit for amount. See, amount again, quantity of substance. So it's a quantity of substance. All right, substance. All right, any substance can be written in moles. Okay, any substance can be written in moles. I can have moles of aluminum. I can have moles of sodium. I can have a moles of sodium chloride. All right, anything. All right, I can convert anything to moles. All right, so that is what kind of we're getting across here, is the mole is a huge number to represent very, very small particles. So particles of sodium and particles of aluminum, particles of sodium chloride, those are very, very small. All right, atoms are very, very small. So how to do calculations with this? So our mole conversion chart, this is a very useful chart if you have not written it down in your notebook. Make sure you write this chart down. All right, so it explains us a couple of things here. It explains us how to convert for atoms and moles and grams, okay? It explains a way to convert in between each one of those. All right, so you're using Avogadro's number and you're using a thing called the molar mass. Now the molar mass can be found on the periodic table. All right, the molar mass is the atomic number. No, not atomic number, atomic mass. All right. So usually that is a decimal number. All right, so it's a decimal number. Okay, it's going to be like for aluminum, it's equal to like 26.98. All right, aluminum's mass is 26.98, so its molar mass is 26.98. Okay, so up to now we know atomic mass as AMU. All right, atomic mass units. Now we're going to be referring to that as grams per mole. All right, or the molar mass. So molar mass is always units, grams per mole. So write that down. All right, so a few things to remember. Okay, write down this chart. Okay, it tells you what to do to convert between these. There will be another video that deals with those conversions, but until we practice it in class, you know, and then I'll answer some questions about it. All right, thanks for listening.